Good morning. Good to have you here this morning. We're so excited to be in the house of the Lord and present with you and worshiping this morning. We've got so many things going on because it's fall. We're moving into fall. It's still summer. So this Thursday night, ladies at the lake. It's ladies night. Ladies, it's ladies night at 6:30 at Tack Island, 11 Wedge Terrace. Bring the attire is swimsuit, flip-flops, and a towel. But we're doing a scrunchie exchange. So you got to bring a fun scrunchie with you, okay? And we're going to play an exchange game. So be there. Let us know because we are going to have food. Women need food. And rest assured, we'll be doing s'mores. So ladies' night this Thursday at 6:30. What's going on? Look, it's expanding.
Oh, yeah, we got lots of stuff for the military packing party. Man, we actually do have a lot of stuff and a lot of stuff coming in. If you haven't done so already, we are accepting donations through, September 10th?
10th. 10th is the day.
September 10th. We need everything and anything you can provide. Some of the hot ticket items are any kind of instant food or drink, white socks, ramen noodles, puzzle books, just regular books, pencils, paper clips, anything. Just anything.
Or look at the list.
Or we could look at the list. We got lists ready and available for you. If they're not on your table, they're in the back there. Please feel free to grab one or 20, hand them out, and get them all in here before September 10th, and then we'll have a packing party and get this stuff out there to all of our military personnel out there on the front lines doing it for us.
Yep, we want to get ready for their Christmas packages. Speaking of Christmas, anybody thinking of Christmas yet? Christmas musical auditions for speaking parts for second grade and up will be next Sunday right after service and will go very quickly. It won't be a long time because many of you are already well known in terms of your talent. So come on out if you're interested in the speaking part. And then September 10th, everything begins. So Christmas musical practice, 12:30 to 2:30, lunch included for kindergarten and up. And we'll be doing our Christmas musical for the next several months and weeks. So join us for that. It's a fun time and exciting time in the life of our church. And then at 2:30 on the 10th of September, AIM is getting together, and they're going to help us with the packing, the military packing as well. And then at 4 o'clock,
Anchor.
Enough said. Be there. Yeah. And then there's the Kingdom Conference.
Kingdom Youth Conference is coming up. It's coming up quick. We're already starting to get some deposits in, so thank you, Early Birds, for locking it down. But deposits are due by September 10th when everything else is happening. $50 I think it's $50 for the deposit, and then the 25 bucks for the deposit. We'll get your name on the list, and then on the 22nd, we're getting out of here. We'll pick you up early from school. Woohoo! Pick you up early from school. Woohoo! And we'll hit the road. We'll go down to the Kingdom Youth Conference. Check that out, and scoot back Saturday night. I think the conference ends around 9 o'clock, so it's a really quick turnaround. Hoping to get high on that mountaintop, come back, and start spreading the good news and the love in our own communities.
So we're excited about that. There's a sign-up list in the back. Some of you have done that already, but we really do need to know if you're going because there's room and rooming situations we have to reserve. So, and then on September 13th, Wednesday night Bible study, 7 o'clock in Newgate for adults, and women's Bible study Thursday, September 14th, 7 o'clock in the Newgate as well. So lots of great things going on. If you were at baptism last week and you had a pink sweater on or a green shirt and left without your shirt or a pair of sunglasses, I have the lost and found over in this area.
And
they were cheap sunglasses. I think there's a song, cheap, but you don't have to play it, Brandon. We're going to sing Happy Birthday. We've got a birthday girl in the house.
Carson!
Yeah! Woo! Woo! And an almost birthday girl, Lucy. And whoa, that's this week, this Thursday. Any other birthdays happening in the house? Braden?
Sweet 16.
Is that really?
Yeah, next week.
Oh, it's not sweet. But he's just 16? He's sweet. Sour. He's sweet 16. Oh, it's next week?
Salty.
Thursday. Oh, it's this Thursday. You and Lucy share a birthday. So the youngest is Carson, and then Brandon, and then Lucy.
Well, young lady.
Any others?
Who else wants to get embarrassed?
All right. You want to start?
No.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brandon. Happy birthday to you. All right, well, let's stand and let's greet one another and let's worship God. It's great to be in the house of the Lord this morning.
Oh, yeah, Chase Bottom.
Charlie, I unplugged my guitar by accident. Stepped on it. All right. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Oh, they're sleeping out there. They're sleeping. Yeah, shoot. Anybody out there? All right. Well, we're going to kick it off with the river, so hopefully you're ready to sing and worship a little bit.
I know a place where we can go to let the troubles down eating your soul. I know a place where mercy flows. Take the stains, make it whiter than snow. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes it come alive. Living water that brings the dead to life. Oh, we're going down to the river, down to the river, down to the river to pray. Let's get washed by the water, washed by the water, rise up in amazing grace. Let's go down, down, down to the river. You will lead change. Let's go down. I've seen it move in my own life. Took me from dusty roads into paradise. All of my dirt, all of my shame, drowned in the streams that have made me born again. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes it come alive. Living water that brings the dead to life. Oh. We're going down to the river, down to the river, down to the river to pray. Let's get washed by the water, washed by the water, rise up in amazing grace. Let's go down, down, down to the river, and we'll lead change. Let's go down. Going down to the river, down to the river, down to the river to pray. Let's get washed by the water, washed by the water, rise up in amazing grace. Let's go down, down, down to the river. You will lead change. Let's go down, down, down to the river.
you guys are out there. Yeah, all right. We woke them up. So it's a new one for us. We're going to do In the House. I chose this one because, well, I and Lauren and Lily. Lily's not here today. We all got baptized last week, and this song talks about celebrating that, and so felt it fit for this week. Capo 4, if anybody who forgot. For me. Just talking to myself.
Has it been a long night? Maybe been a long year, maybe been a hard life. Maybe you're not alright. If you got a little red in your eyes, you've come to the right place. People like you, people like me, this is where we all find grace. Come on now. Bet you wanna sing hallelujah. Bet you'll say amen. To find your rest. It's a crazy world out there. Got some hope in the wilderness. If you're needing water for your soul, well, you're in the right place. Doesn't matter if you're rich or poor, whoever you are, this is where we all find grace. Come on now. Bet you wanna sing hallelujah. Bet you'll say your amen. Can't help but celebrate. Burden, you can lay them down at the door. There is no fear, you belong here. Step into the house of the Lord. Bring your heartache, bring your burden. You can lay them down at the door. Ain't it so clear, you belong here. Step into the house of the Lord. Bet you wanna sing hallelujah. Bet you'll say amen. Celebrate being born again. Somebody who loves you is waiting at the door. It's home sweet home here in the house of the Lord. Bring your heartache, bring your burden. You can lay them down at the door. There is no fear, you belong here. Step into the house of the Lord. I speak to you, would you even hear? What would I even say? How do I speak to you? They tell me you're always there. How do I reach out to you? Would you even listen? Moment, live in the moment where God is. Live in the present, live in the present where God lives. Live in the moment, live in the moment where God is. Live in His presence. now that I felt your love, know that you are listening. I asked you about my mistakes, you told me it'll be okay. Live in the moment, live in the moment where God is. Live in the present, live in the present where God lives. Surrender, surrender, surrender over to you. I just wanna surrender, surrender, surrender over to you. I just wanna surrender, surrender, surrender over to you. I just wanna surrender, surrender, surrender over to you. Would you be my voice? You said I'd find my way. My heart gave it away to you. Live in the moment, live in the moment where God is. Live in His presence, live in His presence where God lives. Live in the moment.
Father, we thank you for this opportunity to worship and to be present in this moment with you and with each other. God, I thank you for every single person in this building that's here to learn about you, to fellowship with other believers, and to seek your presence, Father. Lord, in this moment, would you teach us? Would you unfold the word, reveal your mysteries to us. Lord, help us understand, accept, and apply your word into our lives. And as we learn to love each other and to mirror you, Father, we thank you. We thank you with the breath that's in our lungs, with the ideas in our minds, and with the light that's in our lives. Father, teach us to be as compassionate with one another as you are with us. Teach us to forgive one another as you forgive us. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we love you, and we praise you. And it's in your Son, Jesus Christ's name, that we pray. Amen.
Good morning. as slowly he departs from the stage. So the first prayer request we have is for our worship leader and our brother in Christ, for Curtis, for his back, for the pain, for healing, for diagnosis, and for him to move in the direction of medical care. So we pray that we know even in this moment God could visit him and land on him and bring that healing. And we would pray that first and foremost. And if God chooses not to do that this morning, then we pray that he gets the help that he needs and he can move again and be without pain. So it's heavy on our heart this morning. And I, for one, am so glad he was able to make it today. Would I get an amen on that? Thank you for leading us in worship. So we lift you up, Curtis. Patrick Dwiggins asked for prayer this week, and he said that his father's in hospice, and he's probably going to pass before church on Sunday, so he was enlisting prayer requests. And I've tried contacting him, so I don't know if his dad passed away or not at this point, but I just want to lift up Patrick and his family and just as his father is leaving this world and going to the next, we want to pray for him. We want to continue to lift up prayers for our brothers and sisters in Hawaii, the challenges. We pray for relief efforts, disaster relief to continue. And I want to give you an update on baby Hollis. Shared last week that the pains they had, their baby girl, on Friday night, as it turned out, and went into great respiratory distress and almost failure on Saturday. And UVA emergency team came to Martha Jefferson and were able to transport her, intubate her, and transport her. So we celebrated Sunday that there was some great movement, and there continued to be great movement. And 2 days ago, we just had a little, regression. But as of yesterday, the PICC line in her arm was taken out, and they were able to hold her again. They're able to, through the feeding tube, give breast milk. And the prayer really is the CPAP machine, which had to be reinstated, that she would be ready for that to leave, that more health and more normalcy for this family would continue. So we said we're out of the woods, and then we kind of visited some the edge of the woods, and my prayer would be that we turn the corner now. We just turn the corner, we get out of NICU in a record time and get into a room and get home. So please echo me with those prayers for the family. They're exhausted. They're blessed by the prayers that and the support that they received. So those are the heavy on our hearts this morning. So I'd like to invite us to go into the presence of the Lord and live in this moment and pray in this moment for those on this list and those that are on your heart, and the challenges, the battles that you're facing. I just want to also share Emil Sampiel, Reverend Emil Sampiel, thanks to Terry and Kenny, got transported back to Liberia, so he's halfway home and making his way back, so we'll see him soon in January. So we're grateful for his time with us and for his time with his family. Let's pray this morning. God, thank you for the beauty of the rain. Thank you for how you water the earth, but you also water our souls. God, fill our cup this morning as we enter into your presence, as we just need a refreshing rain in our lives, as we need some renewal, some strength, some help, some hope. Some of us need some healing in the direction in our lives, with relationships or even with our physical bodies, Lord. And we would just ask for your presence, your power, as our Father, as our Savior. Lord, we pray that you would touch us this morning, that we've already received so many answers to prayers, and we just are grateful people. We pray for those who are struggling mightily to recoup what's been lost, to reclaim life in Hawaii and Maui. So, Lord, we ask for your call to help from others in the United States and beyond to enlist in the relief efforts for these people who have been ravaged by these wildfires, Lord. We pray your mercy, your grace, your power, and your presence in their direction. Most of all, we pray that there would be hope, hope to carry on, to find a new way of life, and that you'd be part of that discovery. We pray for our Curtis, and we pray, Lord, that you would bring comfort and rest to him as he's busy about his father's work and family work and life, Lord. We just ask that you restore a level of comfort and healing in his direction. We pray for Patrick, his father, his family, Lord, in this time of sorrow and passing. And we ask that you'd be very, very present and that you'd bring holy comfort and peace in their direction. We pray for this baby Hollis. We pray, Lord, for your will to be accomplished, your glory to be made known. We are a grateful people that you see child, and as you usher her back into the arms of her family, Lord, we give thanks. We pray that things would be removed one at a time, and this child would breathe on her own, breathe in the life that comes from you, Holy Spirit. Strengthen this family, give them rest, give them peace, and may the love of our Savior and the love of their family and friends undergird and support them in these very hard and difficult days. God, we have hope and we have faith and we have lots of love, so we pray that they would collide together in the life of the Payne family and that they'd be victorious, living and being. We pray all these things. We pray things that we carried in today, we lift them up to you. We pray that all would be accomplished in your way and in your time. We wait upon you and give thanks this morning. Amen. Amen. Well, as we take an offering this morning, I just want to share a song, an oldie but a goodie, as we take this offering, and know that everything you give goes for kingdom purposes and changes the world so that there'd be a difference in people's lives. So enjoy it. Well, today is the last sermon in our August message series called Kingdom Living. And we've been teaching about some of the values and practices that Christ followers incorporate in their way of living and actually being. The first week, if you remember, we talked about sharing the Lord's Supper, what that means and what it looks like as kingdom people, fellowshipping and sharing the body and the blood of Christ. And 2 weeks ago, Brian talked about the meaning of baptism and the ritual of baptism that Christ followers participate in. And last Sunday, we celebrated baptism in our own faith community, and what a glorious, glorious day it was. Well, last Sunday, I tried to unpack the privilege and the experience of favor, how we understand and receive favor from the Lord, how we can identify the Lord's favor at work in our lives, and how we can pray for favor. Today's sermon is called Compassion. We just listened to an old worship song from during our offering, and it's called Mighty to Save. Chances are, by Hillsong Worship. Chances are, if you were anywhere on a faith journey and going to church about 10 years ago, you absolutely heard or sang this song. Some of you know the first long line in this song, right? Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never, let mercy. Well, Marianne knows it. I guess she was the only one on the journey over 10 years ago. But compassion is another incredibly strong value in the kingdom of God. We're in the kingdom of God. We're trying to live in the kingdom of God here on earth and in eternity. And compassion is a value that is so important as kingdom people. The Old Testament is filled with scriptures about God's compassion that his people, they recited over and over again in Psalms, in every book in the Old Testament. There's scriptures like this one in the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 18. Therefore, the Lord is waiting to show you mercy and rising up to show you compassion. For the Lord is a just God, and all who patiently are waiting for him are happy. They're blessed. The definition of compassion is a feeling of deep sympathy and sorrow for another who is hurting in pain or has misfortune. And it's accompanied by a strong desire to help the suffering. God's people knew God. They knew God as one who loved and cared for them in their pain, in their illness, in their sufferings. But when we look at the word compassion in the New Testament, we find that it's translated from the Greek word splagnesomai. Say it with me. Splagnesomai. Splagnesomai. That's hard. Greek is hard. But in Greek, splagnesomai means stirring up in the inward parts. Literally, it means twisting in the intestines. The feeling of compassion is a feeling that comes from within, from your insides. It's a gut-wrenching feeling, a feeling that moves you. Jesus Christ is the greatest example of someone with true compassion. We read about the compassion when he saw all the people were just coming to him when he started his ministry and his ministry was made known. Can you imagine how they just hounded and sought after him? And Matthew 9, chapter 9, verses 35 through 38 describes that kind of compassion. 9, verse 35. Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." Many of you know I'm more than a fan. I'm a follower of the series Chosen. And I want to show you a scene from an episode about the healing of a leper that is titled Indescribable Compassion. Take a look at this.
Not to spoil this beautiful day or anything. Huh? Come on.
It's a leper. Stay back. Cover your mouth. Don't breathe his air. Don't come any closer.
It's okay, John. It's okay.
Rabbi,
you cannot.
His disease, you can't.
Please. Please don't turn away from me. I won't.
Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Only if you want to, I submit to you. My sister, she was a servant at the wedding. She told me what you can do. I know you can heal me if you are willing.
I knew it.
What can I ever do?
Do not say anything to anyone.
You don't seek your own honor?
Please just do me this one thing.
But what do I tell people?
Go, show yourself to the priest. Let them inspect you and see that you are cleansed. Make the proper offering in the temple as Moses commanded. And go on your way.
Who has an extra tunic? Just one of you. That's enough. Green is definitely your color. Not too shabby.
Hey, it's Dallas. I'm the creator of The Chosen, and if you'd like...
That's Dallas. Thank you, Dallas. Did you see the disciples? Response to the suffering of the leper versus Jesus' response. Jesus not only healed the sick, but Jesus fed crowds, that thousands that were hungry, that were following him. He was moved by compassion when he saw a funeral procession and a widow's son who was dead. He raised the son from the dead. And he was moved by compassion when his friend Lazarus was in the tomb and dead for 4 days. He called him out and raised him from death to life. But perhaps Jesus' greatest display of compassion for mankind was when he died on Calvary for our sins on the cross. Paul writes in the book of Philippians about our call to imitate the compassion of Christ. Philippians 2, 1 through 3. Therefore, Paul's writing to the church, therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being in one spirit and of one mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves. Everyone should look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interest of others. It's not always easy to show compassion. I had read a while back this meme on Facebook, and I was moved by what I heard or what I read about the human race. And maybe you've read it, maybe you've encountered it if you're on Facebook. Anthropologist Margaret Mead was asked by a student what she thought was the earliest sign of a civilized society. To the student's response, Mead replied that the first sign of civilization is a healed human femur, the long bone that connects the hip. Mead proceeded to explain that wounded animals in the wild would be hunted and eaten before their broken bones could heal. Thus, a healed femur is a sign that a wounded person must have received help from others. Mead is said to have concluded helping someone else through difficulty is where civilization starts. I was so moved by that, I wanted to go back and share that in this message on compassion. And so when I was Googling to find the quote again, I discovered that this happy discovery was not true. Margaret Mead never said that or anything close to that. In fact, she cited that the discovery of some broken bones revealed human violence against other human beings. I was sorely disappointed. Yet, you just can't believe everything you read on Facebook. I know that, but dang. What that shows or helps us understand is that human beings left to our own devices, not so good. But God gives us the gift of the Holy Spirit that we might imitate Christ, develop and live out the character of Christ. Like the song says, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're given that directive in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 through 4. Paul writes, praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all of our troubles so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God. We receive his comfort, we're comforted, and then we're called to comfort those in need. I have a friend who I've spent a lot of time with on the mission field over all these past years. And for me, the mission field is an absolute guarantee to grow compassion. If you're not very compassionate, get on mission and find out the compassion of Christ, because it will visit you. It will touch you. It will change you, hopefully forever. But I have this friend, and whenever you talk about mercy or compassion, she says, I don't have that gift. It's like, yes, you did. I don't have that gift. I married my husband because he has all that gift. But the truth is, that whenever there's a baby that needed holding or helping or resources that were needed to send a child or an adult to the hospital quickly, that there were great needs, She was the first one to open up her pocketbook and provide from her resources. I read a line in one of our devotions in the Word for Today 1 or 2 weeks back, and maybe you came across it, but it kind of rocked me from the inside out. It said, live in such a way you can always be generous. They're not just talking about money. Live in such a way, a kingdom way, that you can always be generous. I thought, that's kingdom living. That I will always be able to be willing to share my time, my giftedness, my resources, most of all, my compassion for those in need. It's hard to look at some of the photos. I showed you one last week of a little girl with a tumor. Darl Zeta sent us to pray, and we're praying for her biopsy results, which haven't come in. Or that gnarly tumor from Elijah a year ago that they just did surgery after surgery, saved his life in Staten Island, went home to Liberia. We got to see him. And then the next day, discovered that the gnarly tumor was back, and now he's back in Staten Island. Those doctors are generous and compassionate. That tumor started all over again. When you look at those tumors, you can't help but have compassion. Can you imagine your child having a tumor on the side of her head like the one we showed last week? How can you not have some twisting in your intestines, some gut-wrenching move, feeling, and make you move in some way? What happens when you watch the television and you see the devastation or the suffering and the destruction that people are experiencing from floods, hurricanes, tornadoes, and now wildfires? Have you been affected by it? Do you feel sad or uncomfortable? Do you feel moved? Moved to do something? Or is it just gut-wrenching and you just have to look at my old way, change the channel, change the channel? Like the SPCA one where they sing and they show, like, I have to change the channel. My gut is just. Last week I shared one of our families had a baby, and the baby was in respiratory distress Saturday afternoonish. And when I got the call, it was even worse because I know the person. My insides were sick. I knew the baby was in danger of dying. I was moved to text everyone I knew that would pray. And the prayer response was tremendous. And you all, if you were here, you all felt the joy when we heard some progress last Sunday. And people started texting and they wanted to offer meals and gift cards and or rides for the children, or just went on and on. That, my friends, is compassion. It's funny that all the things the family was asked or said, can we help with, the greatest thing they valued was our prayers. Paul writes to the church in the book of Colossians, and this title over this section is called The Christian Life. He writes, Colossians 3:12, therefore, as God's chosen ones, holy and dearly beloved, put on compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. We may not have the time at a moment, we may not have the resources at the moment, but we are moved to do something. And prayer can be one of the most powerful, great gifts that we can give. May we desire to be Christ followers that live in the kingdom here on earth in such a way that the whole world, our corner of the whole world, might see the glory of God, the love of God, and the compassion of Christ in us. May we live in such a way that we can always be generous. Let us pray. King of the universe, King of glory, God of compassion, may we, your people, desire to be more like you in every facet of our lives, with how we work, how we play, how we speak, how we pray, how we use our time, our energy, and our resources, how we communicate to one another in person or on social media. May we be moved by splagnitsomai to the interest and needs and concerns of others as well as ourselves, that all may see you alive in us and working in our world. Oh, we pray, land on us this morning from the inside out, that compassion would be an attire we wear. We pray, Jesus, to be like you this morning. Amen. Well, as we stand and as we sing and as we close this time of gathering, I pray that your desire to live as a Christ follower in the kingdom, which is not an easy thing to do, that it would be blossoming, that it would be stirring up in you, that you would find out how capable and able you are in the little and the big things, that you would go where God calls you, invites you, blesses you, and that you would see, that you would recognize his work in your life. You matter. You have a purpose, and he's designed you for a purpose to impact the world. So we celebrate that. We celebrate that we were lost, but now we're found, and we're in the kingdom. Can we live in a kingdom in such a way that it matters, that it's different, and things change? Gosh, if we don't believe in that, then there's nothing to believe in. So let's stand, and if you need prayer, if you need encouragement, if you need some compassion, we're here, and we'd love to pray with you.
Thank you.
When Curtis said he was doing this song for Invitation, I didn't realize he understood splagnitsomai. This fire in his soul is twisting in your gut, is compassion. May the compassion of Christ be with us, be for us, and let our light so shine in all the places God sends us, uses us, and gives us today. Let us live in such a way we can be generous with all things, with all people, in all ways. God bless you today.